Hello friends, in this second video lecture of electrolytic conductivity, today we will discuss differentiation between electronic and electrolytic conductor. As we have already explained both the terms in our last lecture, so in image you can see here, this is the image for electronic conductor and this one is the image for electrolytic conductor. So this is the electrolysis of sodium chloride, you can see in diagram, and there are number of metal wires, so that is nothing but metallic conductor or simply electronic conductors. So when there is a question, differentiate between electronic and electrolytic conductors in your exam, so you have to write 4 to 5 points for getting the appropriate marks. We will explain one by one. So this one is left hand side is of electronic or metallic conductor and right hand side is of electrolytic conductor. So now the first point is electricity is conducted by the flow of mobile electron. That means free electrons are available in case of metallic conductors or electronic conductors, and because of that free electrons, electricity can be flow whenever we have applied electric field to that conductor. But in case of electrolytic conductor, if you see, the electric current is carried by the movement of positive and negative ions. So presence of positive and negative ions in case of electrolytic conductor, there is no any kind of free electrons available, so because of which current is carried by the movement of positive and negative ions. So now in second point, during conduction of electricity, no any chemical change occurs. So chemical change is related with the chemical reaction. It may be oxidation, it may be reduction. So such kind of reaction doesn't followed by the electronic conductors, because of which no any chemical change occurs. But at the same time, if you see the electrolysis of NaCl, at that time conduction of electricity is accompanied by some definite chemical change, means some type of chemical reaction is happening in case of electrolytic conductors. That means it may be oxidation, it may be reduction, or any other. So there is an occurrence of chemical change. Then conduction of electricity does not involve the transfer of matter. Now there is no any kind of chemical change, so there is no question arise of the transfer of matter, because electricity is totally depends on the free electron in case of metallic conductors, so because of which no transfer of matter. But there is a chemical change because of which there is a transfer of matter. So conduction involves transfer of matter in the form of ions. Now the fourth one, conduction of metallic conductor decreases with increase of temperature. Manje jyavelis temperature vadte tyavelis metallic conductor cha conductance ha kami hoto. Tar ya magcha reason asa ahe की जेव्हा आपण टेम्परेचर एखाद्या कंडक्टरला देतो त्यावेळेस यामध्ये स्टेबल पॉझिटिव्ह चार्जेस आणि फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स असे दोन प्रकार आढळून येतात. तर जे काय फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आहेत, जे फ्रीली मूव होत आहेत, यांना टेम्परेचर दिल्यानंतर जे काय पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज आहेत, जे स्टेबल आहेत, ते व्हायब्रेट झाल्यामुळे ऍक्टिव्ह होतात अँड दे क्रिएट डिस्टर्बन्स टू द दॅट रनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, अँड बिकॉज ऑफ डिस्टर्बन्स दॅट इज नथिंग बट क्रिएशन ऑफ रेझिस्टन्स इज देअर. आणि जेव्हा रेझिस्टन्स तयार होतो त्यावेळेस त्यांचा स्पीड कमी होतो, त्यामुळं इलेक्ट्रॉनला तयार झालेल्या रेझिस्टन्समुळं कंडक्टन्स ऑफ मेटॅलिक कंडक्टर डिक्रीजेस. रेझिस्टन्स वाढला की ऑटोमॅटिक कंडक्टन्स हा कमी होतो, रेझिस्टन्स कमी झाला की कंडक्टन्स हा वाढतो. सो दिस पॉइंट इज नथिंग बट अबाउट द रेझिस्टन्स विच इज क्रिएटेड ड्यू टू दॅट स्टेबल पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज विच इज ऑकरिंग बिकॉज ऑफ इन्क्रीज इन टेम्परेचर. बट at the same time, if you observe for electrolytic conductor, if you increase the temperature, conductance increases with increase in temperature. Now there are positive ions and negative ions and both are moving, no anyone is stable, So if both are moving, if you increase the temperature, kinetic energy of both the ions, that is positive as well as negative ion, increases, because of which speed increases, and speed increases, then conductance increases. Now the last point is of examples. They are usually metals, that is metallic conductor. So these are usually metals like aluminium, copper, metallic rods or metallic wires. Just as shown in first slide, if you see here, there are number of wires that may be of copper, aluminium wires are inserted here. That is the metallic conductor. So that is the best example of metallic conductors. Now in case of electrolytic conductor, best examples are fused salt, aqueous solution of acid bases, and salt as like NaCl, KCl, just we have seen in the first diagram. That is the NaCl, Na plus, Cl minus, and this is the aqueous solution. Anode cathode is also present. So these are the salt, aqueous solution of any acid, any base or any salt. That is the best example for electrolytic conductors. So in this way, you have to write any 4 to 5 points for getting the correct mark in your exam. So the next point of this topic we will discuss in the next video lecture. Thank you.